Well, look at this. The engine is back in the car. And I bought these to weld the floor and the bulkhead too. And I'm gonna have them like this. So I'm gonna drill those and have these fastened there and there. And that should be plenty strong. Yeah. Hello and welcome to this episode of This Bastard. Today I'm going to start building up the body for it. The bulkhead and the floor and stuff like that. So I can attach brake pedal, gas pedal, brake lines. Yeah, stuff like that. So yeah. Also, I got the hold of two quite nice Range Rover seats. Nice is in nice condition, not nice is in a nice color. This is quite ugly color, but hey, they have the seat belt attached to the back of the chair, so I just need to have a strong floor and good quality bolts, and this is going to be okay. Quite cool. They need a bit of service. So yeah, quite nice, strong floor, and this will be good. When the bulkhead is set straight up, I'm thinking about making two ears out from this one on both sides, so I can bolt this through the hole that it's supposed to be bolt on. If this was a right-hand drive car, this would be the gas pedal. Also, here's this steering column. So this is set for both right and left-hand drive. Measure where this is going to be lengthwise, and I will drill holes in both ends so I can attach this to this. Woo! Yeah, sidetrack. This was full of moss and grass and branches, small branches. So this has been a bird nest. So I just cut a hole in it. I'm gonna weld that back. I mean, I got a huge chunk of shit out of this one. So I need to clean this too. Yeah, it fits. I just need to cut this little ear off. Nice. This is going to be sitting like this. This one is going to be a bit higher, like this much higher. As you see, it's going to be quite perfect with the floor. Will be level with this, so I can weld the floor directly to this one. And that's going to make for a quite strong impact thing. If a child on a bicycle comes and run into the car, we will survive. So that's good. Now I need to drill those holes bigger, so the head of the bolt goes through, and I going to have rubber inside this one, so it's going to be like that. There we go. I'm just test fitting fenders and bonnet and grill. I want to make measurements where the radiator fits, and also I just want to see how it looks. I'm going to measure the center wheel to the center fender wheel well here, see where if it looks all right. I just want to check if my measurements are correct, and they seem to be. It looks a little bit like a car again, and that's good. So I'm going to take the hood off again. I just wanted to check the grill. The holes in the fenders for the grill are slotted about 20 millimeters, so I can move the grille a bit, but I want the edge of the bonnet here to go over the grille. I think that looks best. Hopefully I can make the radiator fit. The clearance for the spinny dizzy and the air cleaner is about 25-30 millimeters, so that's pretty good. As you can see, the steering box makes the radiator to be eccentric this direction, so it will be moved over to the right side. And I need to, I'm going to remove this angle iron. The radiator will fit under this one. I just need to make a hole for the radiator cap, and that hole is going right where this label is. I want to save that one, of course. It's cool. So I'm just going to move that one over, probably here, and I need to cut the headlight. Need to be cut as well, because the radiator is going all the way to the frame. It will fit between the frame and the steering box. Well, so I hope this radiator, which is built for this engine but in a different car, will keep the engine cool. So here we go. That's moved. So yeah, if you like this episode, give it a thumbs up, subscribe. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Yeah, see you on the next one. Ooh. Just a second.